Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Constructing Minds. In this video, we shall be looking at the recent ruling of the Gujarat High Court in the case of Material Recycling Association of India, wherein it has upheld the validity of Section 13 Subsection 8 Clause B, read with Section 2 Subsection 13 of the IGST Act, and held that the service provided by intermediary in India cannot be treated as export of services under the IGST Act 2017. Let us first look at the facts of the case. The petitioner, Material Recycling Association of India, is an association comprising the recycling industry engaged in the manufacturing of metals and casting for various industries in India. It is engaged in providing business promotion and marketing services for principals located outside India. The petitioner facilitates the sale of goods by foreign principals to their customers in India. The petitioner has no role in the actual sale and purchase of goods supplied by the foreign clients. The petitioner receives commission on sale receipts by the foreign client. According to the petitioner, the services provided by them should be covered under export of services. Now, let us look at the definition of export of services as given under the IGST Act. To qualify as an export of service, 5 criteria must be satisfied, which are: the supplier of service should be located in India, the recipient of service should be located outside India, the place of supply of service shall be outside India, the payment of such service should be received by the supplier in convertible foreign exchange, and the supplier of service and the recipient of service should not merely be establishments of a distinct person. In this case, the dispute is regarding the place of supply of service. Now, let us look at the definition of intermediary services. Intermediary services have been defined under Section 2 Subsection 13 of the IGST Act 2017, which is as under. Intermediaries means a broker, an agent, or any other person by whatever name called, who arranges or facilitates the supply of goods or services or both between two or more persons, but does not include a person who supplies such goods or services or both on his own account. The place of supply of service, in case where the location of a recipient of service is outside India, is dealt under Section 13 of the IGST Act. It provides that the place of supply of service in case of an intermediary service is the location of the supplier. Hence, in this case, the services provided by the petitioner will be exigible to GST. Now, let us look at the contentions made by the petitioner. The state has no jurisdiction to impose tax when the supply takes place outside the state. According to Section 13 Subsection 8 Clause B of the IGST Act, such services have been deemed to be provided within the state, in spite the recipient being actually outside the state. Hence, the petitioner has contended that Section 13 Subsection 8 Clause B is ultra vires the Constitution and is unreasonable. The petitioner has further contended that no tax is levied in case the intermediary is located outside India and the recipient of service is also located outside India. Hence, according to the petitioner, the services provided by them should be treated as export of services. Now, let's move on to the contentions made by the respondent. The respondent has contended that the transaction of the petitioner will not be covered under export of service since it is not satisfying one of the conditions of place of supply being outside India, as enumerated in Section 2 of the IGST Act 2017. Further, it is contended that being a policy decision of the government, GST levy cannot be said to be unlawful or violating the tenets of the Constitution. It has also been contended that Section 13 Subsection 8 is not violative of the Constitution. The Honorable Gujarat High Court has held that the services provided by the intermediary in India cannot be treated as export of service under the IGST Act. Further, it has been held that the provision of Section 13, Subsection 8, Clause B of the IGST Act are neither ultra vires nor unconstitutional in any manner. Further, the court has mentioned that it is open for the petitioner to make representation before the government to resolve their grievance in a suitable manner. So that's all for this video. Thanks a lot for watching and stay tuned for such videos. Thanks a lot.